Hey there, what's going on? If you're watching this video, I guess you are wondering what's the best way to prepare yourself for the iOS 14 changes that have heavily affected Facebook ad performance across industry. Now, that's something which I see happening for my client ad accounts over and over again, and that I had to prepare for, and just to make sure that we are on the safe side and that we don't lose money or that we don't start running ads at lost. So in this video, we're really gonna have it framed into two core sections. The first It's gonna be I'm gonna share with you what it means, the iOS 14 changes, and how to actually and what are the key requirements that you have to make sure that you have in place to ensure that you have a less you have less effect as possible on your ads performance. And afterwards, I'm gonna share with you what we are actually doing internally besides what's recommended by Facebook. Now, in terms of a bit of backstory, iOS 14 changes were coming came into play at the beginning of this year. We've been hearing about them coming into play since mid of last year, since summer 2020. And what it means is basically that Apple moving forward is not gonna give the possibility for its user to not allow to be tracked by Facebook. And usually with the user, since they don't understand what it means to be tracked, they don't realize that being tracked actually means that they end up getting a better user experience because they are seeing ads which are linked to what their preferences actually are. Most users, when they are given the opportunity to opt out of the tracking, on most Apple users, when they are given the opportunity to opt out of the tracking, most of them, most of them have been taking that opportunity to opt out, which means that advertiser, you and I, and business owner are no longer able to track those users or to show the and to show the ads to those users based on what they are watching or based on what they're interested in. Now, this of course has a huge impact on us as advertiser, but even more so on business owner, because it immediately means that there is a decline in audience reach that we can actually see our ads, that we can show our ad to. But there are different things that we can take that we can implement in our strategies to make sure that we have as that we mitigate as much as possible the effects of those new changes. Now, the very first one, which has been even so there are actually two main ones which have been heavily advised by Facebook. The first one being verifying your domain. So here I'm just looking at the Facebook privacy, I mean the Facebook policy when it comes to the iOS 14 changes. And one of the very first thing that you want to do is to verify your domain, because this is going to allow Facebook to make sure that you are showing ads from a domain that you actually own. And verifying your domain is actually very easy. You just so here it's saying so here you basically have the article that in which they share with you how to go about verifying your domain on the Business Manager. So what you want to do is basically come onto your Business Manager, how it looks like. This is a backup account which I'm using for training purposes and for tutorials video. That's why there's nothing here. But when it comes to verifying your domain, what you want to do in your account, you want to click on All tools, go on to business settings, and then you scroll down to point safety. Once you scroll down in here on point safety, you click on domains, and this is basically where you will have your domain, and you basically want to add the DNS text to your host provider or the website in which your domain is linked, be it Shopify, ClickFunnel, Bluehost. It's so I don't have anything because this again is a tutorial account, but it's you have all the details explained here in terms of how to actually go about verifying your domains. But this is actually the this is the first step that you want to have, like verify your domain, and you have like three options when it comes to doing so, depending on where your domain is hosted. Now, this again is the very first step. The second step, when it comes to preparing yourself for or mitigating the effect of the Apple 14 changes on your Facebook ads, is to prioritize your eight events. What happened in the past is that Facebook were allowing advertisers to just choose as many events as possible in when running conversion campaign, which means that when you run a conversion campaign, you basically tell Facebook, okay, I want to optimize this campaign for a specific event, which might be a purchase, which might be a registration, a opt-in, you know. And based on those events that you had chosen, Facebook will go ahead and choose and, you know, put your ads in front of people that were most likely to actually put your ad in front of people who are most likely to take that specific event. And we used to have over 12 events to choose from. But now with iOS 14 change, we are limited to only five, I mean, to only eight events. So you really want to make sure that you choose the right one and that you choose the one that actually That matters most to your business. So if you are, for instance, in the e-commerce space, you want to have maybe like page view and initiate checkout, purchase, right? And if you have any upsell on the back end, you can also have other upsell based on what your specific business is. But you want to prioritize those events and actually have them set up in your event manager. So again, to do so, you'll basically go onto your business manager again, and business settings on all tools, business settings, click on event manager. That's where you'll find, this is where your pixel should be saved. If you haven't yet installed a pixel on your site, I've made a video in which I share with you how to install a pixel on your site, because it's very important when it comes to running Facebook ads. And I'll have that video link somewhere here or on the notes of the video. So you basically want to, so this again, it's an account. So let me just show you how it look like, might look like in a real account. I'm just gonna cut that. Afterward. So this is basically how your pixel has to be set up. You have to have like page view, checkout initiated, complete registration, leads, if any. So you really want to prioritize those events. And again, Facebook, there's an article that shows you exactly how to create those events, which is this one here, and show you how to prioritize them based on which industry, based on the industry in which you run your ads. Because based on what your niche is, you're gonna have different events, right? So those are really the two things that you wanna have in mind when it comes to preparing that yourself for the Facebook for the iOS 14 changes. Now, something that you also want to have in mind is that moving forward, there might be a delay in reporting on your dashboard, on your Facebook Ads Manager. So because there's just this something again which comes from as a result of the iOS 14. If you see maybe you like you want to be more patient when it comes to assessing your results, looking at your Facebook Ads Business Manager. So it might take up to 3 days to have the right conversion reported on your Business Manager. And another thing when it comes to reporting limitation is that you might have not all of your event, not all of the action taken, or not all of the sales, for instance, made on your site shown on Facebook. So you definitely want to cross check Facebook with any other reporting tool that you might have, maybe Google Analytics or Wicked Report, based on what you are using, to make sure that you actually, or maybe your backend on Shopify, to make sure that your sales actually, so that you don't get misleading data from Facebook, because there might be a lag, or there might be an underestimation of sales or conversion events from the Facebook ads on the Facebook ad backend. So those are, when it comes to reporting, that's really the two things that you want to have to keep in mind. There might be a delay in reporting, and there also might be, you might have estimated results which are actually different from the real result that you're seeing on your the backend, right? And something else is also that you have now, and that's also come as a result of having shorter Windows attribution. So back in the past, we used to have like 28 days attribution windows coming from Facebook ads, meaning that if someone saw your ads, they click on the ad and they ended up buying your course or your product or whatever you are selling, Facebook could attribute that sales to that specific campaign or to that specific ad set up to 28 days after the sales, after the person had clicked on the ads. But now they've shortened that attribution window to 7 days. So now, after 7 days, the person has not completed an action after they've clicked on your ads, Facebook stopped tracking them, and you basically feel like even though you have the sale, which happens after the seven-day window, that sale will not be reflected on your ads manager. You will, on your CRM, on your reporting tool, you might feel like that sale is coming from somewhere else, or there's no way to track. That's why you always want to, when running ads, you want to make sure that your UTM parameters are well set up, and that's so that you can track any event, any purchase that happens on the back end. I'm just going to show you how to set up a UTM parameters so that you are sure that you're tracking all events coming from Facebook moving forward. And so to track your UTM parameter, you want to be on your ad set. So if I'm, for instance, I come onto this test ad, and I go onto the ad field. So if you scroll down, you see where I say URL parameters. Oh, wait. Yeah, you want to click on build a URL parameter if you don't have one already. So you want to have like campaign. You want to put your campaign name so that it's easy for you to track. Campaign medium, maybe that's going to be for your Facebook ads, right? Campaign name, oh, we already have campaign source there. Campaign name, maybe you can have your ad set name. Oh, wait, hold on. Maybe then here we can have our campaign name here. Campaign source, we can have maybe campaign ID. So you basically choose it as the way that makes more sense to you, which is going to be easy for you to track when you look at the sales on the back end, right? And campaign content, you might maybe put in your ad name if you name your ad based on what they are about. So for, I like to name my ad based on the graphic or the creative that I'm using. So here could be 5 things to improve your Facebook ad campaign or something in those lines. I always name my ad based on the content of the ad itself, based on the creative. So if you are doing the same, then you can have campaign content, which is your ad name. Otherwise, it might be something else. So that's basically how you want to ensure to mitigate the effect of the shortened attribution window, because Facebook is not going to tracking after 7 days. But if you have this set up properly and you click on apply, if you have this set up properly, whenever someone buys, even if they buy after 7 days, you will still be able to see, okay, these are coming from Facebook ads, and you'll be able to properly link the sales to your campaign. Now, some housekeeping item when it comes to actually making sure that your current ad are not affected by what's going on. There are actually 4 things that you want to have in mind when it comes to optimizing the performance of your campaigns after iOS 14 change. The first one is really to make sure that you are monitoring your backend sales, as we've just mentioned, making sure that you are not only relying heavily on Facebook to make sure to understand what's happening, but also keep an eye on what's going on your backend. So that's really the very first one, because not everything will be tracked by Facebook. The second thing that you want to have in mind is to make sure that you are stacking your lookalike audiences, right? Maybe if you are using lookalike audiences based on your website visitor, you might also want to have a lookalike audience based on your page engagement, because you know that not all visitors are going to be tracked by Facebook if they've decided to opt out as a result of iOS 14. So you make sure that you are stacking your audiences, and that you are, because those lookalike audiences based on website visitor, for instance, are going to shrink. So to make sure that there is not a huge loss in size, make sure that you are also adding other lookalike audiences, maybe video viewers, up to a certain percentage, as well as engagement on your page. Those are good audiences to stack on top of what you already have, the website visitor wants. And something else that you also want to prevent when it comes to preparing for lookalike, for when it comes to mitigating the effect of Facebook of the iOS 14, is play with different conversion campaign. Play with different campaign type. If you are heavily relying on Facebook conversion, because those are gonna be the ones that are mostly affected, try to play with other type ad campaigns, such as lead gen, for instance, or messenger ads, right, where you can keep your visitor onto Facebook and funnel them to the page once they are ready and prime to do business with you, right? So with lead gen, of course, there's always a bit of a trade-off between quality and quantity. But nonetheless, if you're doing things properly, if you know how to optimize your ad, if you know how to have a message that actually speaks to the target audience, you will end up with a, let me just show you how it looks like, create a new campaign. If you've done a good job at optimizing your creative and your messaging, using a lead gen campaign instead of conversion can still help you achieve your conversion goals, right? You just have to know how to play with the platform And the same apply for Messenger ads. So you can, instead of sending them directly to Facebook or to your website using conversion campaign, you can also try to funnel them to a Messenger mini chatbot, for instance, and, you know, convert them from there. If you want video on showing you how to actually go about building these different campaigns, let me know on the comment below, and I'll definitely make them. So that's the third thing. So when it comes to mitigating the effect, try different campaigns. Objective, don't rely only on conversion campaign, because these might be the one. These are the ones that are the most affected with the iOS changes. Something which I've seen work well for my client was to after iOS 14 changes were implemented back in June. What I did, I saw a drop in performance for one of my clients, and what I did was basically I shut down that campaign and I basically started from scratch. So I basically rebuilt the whole thing in a different campaign so that Facebook could actually learn from scratch. Basically, I uploaded a new custom audience and I used the same creative, the same copy, but I had everything else changed. Like, I started from scratch. So try also refreshing your campaigns. Basically, maybe if you witness a huge drop in performance of your ads, try turning off that campaign if it's really negatively affected, and turn it and build a new one, right? New convert. I mean, the same event, the same conversion event, but let's say that you were using a custom audience of purchaser or opt-in, right? You want to use an updated version of that custom audience, but have it run with the same creative, same copy as well, especially if that campaign was performing well before Facebook changes, right? So that's, again, something that you can do to mitigate the effect of Facebook, of these changes. The fifth and last thing is really to use your CRM to help you improve your conversion objective. So if you are, for instance, targeting people and you have an email list of people that have bought your product in the past or that have subscribed to your email list, you can use those that list of users as a lookalike audience, you know, and create lookalike audience based on those users, which is really going to allow you to target the same audience without relying heavily on Facebook to feed you with data. So that's definitely something to look into as well. And final one, the bonus one, which I just thought about, is to make sure that you increase your size of your lookalike audience. So if you were, for instance, going for 1% lookalike audience, consider going for 2% lookalike audience, or even 3% lookalike audience. I've seen 3% lookalike audience actually outperforming 1% lookalike audience for one of my clients based in the UK. So you definitely want to play with the size, because again, since the size has shrunk, you want to make sure that you are feeding Facebook with more data so that it can play with and give you better results. So definitely consider as well expanding the size of your lookalike audiences, maybe from 1% to 2% or even 3%. And then, yeah, those are basically the six things that you can do when it comes to preventing ad performance drop after iOS 14 changes. I hope this helps you. If you have any question, let me know in the comment section. I would be happy to help. If you want someone to do this whole heavy lifting for you, definitely reach out. That's what I do all day, every day for my client. I help them generate leads and sales online using Facebook ads. And I would love to help you get those results as well. I hope this video, you got value from this video. If you did, make sure to give the thumbs up so that more people can see it. Subscribe if you are new here. We are all about digital marketing, Facebook ads, and how to grow and scale your business predictably using strategy and tactic when it comes to the digital marketing space. Thank you so much for watching. Again, if you need my help, support, feel free to drop a comment below or click the link in the description to schedule a call to speak with me. I would love to learn how I can help you get better results in 2021 and beyond. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you on the next one. Bye-bye. Take care.